Good morning. Anybody wants a bathroom break and get up, go and come.
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning. You haven't got up after Aarti ma'am's class. All of you get up.
Get up. Why, ma'am?
You should not be continuously sitting. You will get all sorts of aches.
Ma'am, I took a walk. I took a walk and came.
Good. Very nice. That's what I'm saying. If you want to go use the washroom also, go and come. Still, children have to join. So we have time. So those of you who are in the meeting, you can go. Use the washroom and come.
Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, we'll turn off the video or we'll turn videos on?
You turn off the video. When you come back, you turn off the video.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Ma'am, have you given the PDF of the Mauryan Empire?
You all have books, no?
No, no ma'am. Not still.
Yeah.
Right? Yesterday you were supposed to get, no?
Ma'am, actually, I am not in Thane. I'm at my grandma's place in Indore. So my books are in Thane, but I still don't have them.
When are you coming back to Thane, Anushka?
Ma'am, I still don't know. You know, my mom is not letting me travel right now.
Where is your grandma's house, may I ask?
Indore, Madhya Pradesh.
And how will you manage without the books?
Exactly. I am doing with the PDF and all right now. I don't know.
Can you contact one of your friends then to give you? Because, you know, I really don't have storage in my phone. Giving all these PDFs, my phone is complete. Now all of them are having books, so I don't want to do the scanning and sending. Indraneel, please put this thing on.
Sure, ma'am.
Ma'am, I got the books, but I can't use it right now.
Why?
Ma'am, my mother told me the books came from outside, use it after 2 days. I'm telling her I'll sanitize the books to you, but she's not letting me to do.
You don't have to be so much.
I told her, ma'am, but my mother, now she's like, you use it after 2 days, what will happen? You're doing from PDF, now do it for 2 days more. What will happen more?
Oh my God. Okay. I started using the book in the other class. Morning, 9th B, I had a class. We did reading from the book and I marked the answers in the book. How many people are not having their book with them? Can you put it in chat, please? Those are not having. Mannat, you're not having?
Yes, ma'am. I don't have my books.
Why?
Ma'am, because I'm in Nasik right now. I'm not in Mumbai.
But why did you all go away here and there? Before lockdown only you went?
No, ma'am. I'm a new admission, so I haven't shifted yet. I'm going to shift now.
Okay.
Due to lockdown only, I was just going to shift after 2 days the lockdown started, but because of the lockdown I wasn't able to shift. So now I'm going to shift.
I came here the day her exams got over.
Your exams didn't get over also.
Huh, but you know the day our exams were going to end, the 17th, I had booked my tickets on that day, so I came here, and then the day I came here, the next day itself,
was announced.
Yeah.
So if there are only one or two children who are not having, can they get help from their friends is my question. Mannat is a new girl. Who is ready to help Mannat? Who can send? Ria, very good. Ria, can you send to Anushka and Mannat, both of them?
Ma'am, I have the books in Thane, so my mom can send me the photos.
She can send, but since anyway, Ria is doing it. See, Riya is anyway, after marking, she will send. Whatever I give in the class, she will mark. So after marking, she will send it to both you, and it doesn't take time for her. No, she just has to forward. Once she puts it in WhatsApp for one person, for her, it is not difficult to forward.
Okay.
And you will get all the markings. That is the thing. All the markings for the answers you will get. That is why I'm saying. Who else is there? Because Riya has taken up this very wonderful, you know, task of helping others. So if anybody else also wants this kind of help, you will have to tell it right now in the class. Please tell. Mannat and Anushka, you have to give your phone numbers. Mannat, can you give your phone number, please?
Yes, ma'am. I'll send it to her in the chat.
She can't see the chat. The chat, only the, you can chat with the teacher. You can't chat with your friends. So you can tell your number.
So, ma'am, I'll personally take her on my phone.
You don't want to share your number?
Ma'am, it's okay. I can.
Yeah. So your number is anyway in the group. There's nothing to hide.
Yes, ma'am.
So give your number to Riya.
Mom, I think we should start now.
Okay. Anushka, you also give your number to Riya?
Yes. Ma'am, I'll say it out loud or I'll give it
say loudly. Say loudly. Say loudly.
7397.
Yeah.
8707. 12.
I'll repeat it. 73978.
Yeah.
70712.
Yeah. 7397870712.
Yeah.
Ma'am, can I also tell? Ma'am, I'll also give my number. Yes, ma'am. 8788.
Yeah.
257065.
I'll repeat it, okay? 8788257065.
Yeah, it's correct.
Okay, I can see a lot of people who have switched off their videos. Please switch it on. Except those people who have a genuine issue, they will write on the chat informing me what is their problem. Others will go switch on the video, please. Yeah. Okay, let's start the class. Today, did we do up to Pan India? In your this thing, advantages of Pan India, I did, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so, and I also started that thing. I gave you yesterday the tree, na? Provincial administration and we finished the central administration. Okay, we will finish the provincial administration. Then only we'll do, because yours is, you know, almost have finished. So let me finish the PPT and then only we'll start with the textbook. Okay, markings. So let me start the class. Okay. So, wait. Noted. Anushka, Sumir and Richa, I have noted. Yeah. So civil administration. So two types of administration. One is civil administration, military administration. Civil administration has two governments. One is central government, or for the whole kingdom, there is a government, and then there is a provincial government. Provincial government is for the provinces, individual provinces. And yesterday I told you how many provinces were there. Who remembers? Please unmute yourself and tell me how many provinces were there in the Mauryan kingdom.
Five. After the Kalinga five. Was captured, five.
Very good. Before Kalinga, four, and after Kalinga, five. And each province was headed by
prince.
What was the prince called?
Kumara.
Very good. Kumara. So it was headed by a prince, and the prince was called Kumara. Now we are concentrating on central administration. So in central administration, I told you there was the king, and he was assisted by a council of ministers. Okay, he was assisted by a group of people, and they are called the council of ministers or Mantri Parishad. And he also appointed Mahamatras, and these Mahamatras are nothing but officers who looked after the welfare. They did different types of works. Okay, now each in this council of ministers, who all were there? Purohit was there, who was a religious leader. Senapati, who was the leader of the army. Tanidata, who was a treasurer. As I already told you, treasurer is one who takes care of the treasure of the king, who manages all the money. And then Samaharta is the one who calculates the tax, and he has a lot of people to assist him, obviously. He is like the head of the department. So the head of the department of taxation was Samaharta. So Sannidata, Samaharta, Purohit, Senapati. In case you can't remember these names, there is no problem. You please remember treasurer, taxation expert. Can you remember that? So you can write like this. If I ask you, please elaborate government of the Mauryan administration, then you must say that the king was all powerful. He had supreme authority, and the throne was hereditary, and the king was assisted by a council of ministers called the Mantri Parishad. Purohit, Senapati, or treasurer, taxation expert, Purohit and Senapati were some of the ministers who were part of the council of ministers. Okay, you can write like this if you can't remember Sannidata and Samaharta. Purohit and Senapati, I think, is easy to remember. We use it even today. Okay, so this is not difficult. Sannidata, Samaharta, today you may remember, but some of you will still remember, but some may not remember. So those who can at least remember treasurer and taxation expert, that is also fine. Okay, so that is the thing. Then you can say that apart from that, there were other important officers like, you know, officers who were taking care of other departments like mines, ports, weights. At least remember 2-3. Again, there is a big list here. If you remember 2-3 also, it is sufficient for example. So you can say mines, we know mines, we know ports, weights and measures. Weights and measures is an easy thing to remember, because weights and measures talks about how the officers used to check whether, you know, the shopkeepers are using correct weight. You know, they are not cheating the customers by saying they put 1 kg and but they give you only 1/2 kg. Because the weight itself is faulty or it has been tampered with. So to check that they don't do fraud, you have officers who check weights and measures. Now, did you understand what is weights and measures? What is the meaning of that? So this is easy to remember. So if you remember 3 also, it's enough. Mines, ports, weights and measures, etc. Okay, so now so you all understood what is the central government? Very simple 3-4 points we need to remember. That's it. Arjun, can you repeat? I'm going to remove the screen. Can you repeat, Arjun? Tell me about the central government. I can't hear. Unmute yourself. Anybody else? Nobody remembers.
Ma'am, just now.
Yes, please.
The central government had a king which was assisted by council of ministers called as Mantri Parishad. The Mantri Parishad consisted of the Sannidata, and the taxation expert, and Purohit and Senapati. And the other officers were accountant general, then mines, ports, and weights and measures, etc.
Very good. And the ultimate authority lied with the king. That's it. Very good, Shibangi. Why, Arjun, you couldn't remember these points? Arjun, you should answer when I'm taking your name and I'm asking you something. Say yes or no or whatever. Give an answer. Okay. Next. So next we will come to the provincial administration, which is, you know, every area, like today we have states, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat and all. Those days only five provinces. So those five provinces, how were they taken care of? So we already know that every province was under the control of a Kumara or a prince. So the head of the province was a Kumara or Aryaputra. These are all different names. You remember one, that is enough. Kumara. Okay. So it was Kumara. He was a prince and he was assisted by governors called Mahamatras. So Mahamatras is essentially officers. So the in every province there were Mahamatras who assisted the Kumara. Then again here also there is a taxation expert, then there is a revenue officer, treasurer. See, you have all those positions even in the provinces. Okay, naturally those who are doing calculating the tax and all for that particular province is the taxation expert who is called Pradeshika. Okay, and Rajuka is the revenue officer. Again, those who took care of all taxes and again revenue officer and taxes is very close. Okay, revenue officer probably calculated and they decided how much tax that every person has to pay, and the collection was done by Pradeshika. Did you understand? So revenue officers are those who calculated the taxes and Pradeshika are those who actually collected it from the people. Okay. And then Yukta was the treasurer. So just as we have a treasurer, even in the central, government or with the king in the capital city, the capital city of the kingdom, we have the government for the entire country. So just like we have a taxation expert there, we have, one second, just a minute, children. Wait. Hello, sorry children. Yeah. Just like we have a taxation expert there, we also have a taxation expert in the provinces. So remember this. Please remember some of the names. Actually, it is not difficult because I have chosen very few names for you to remember. If you practice, you will be able to do it. Pradeshika, Rajuka and Yukta were the three officers who assisted the Kumara and the Mahamatras. Okay, so Pradeshika collected taxes, Rajuka was a revenue officer, Yukta was a treasurer. You don't even have to give explanation of what they did. You just remember this much, that Pradeshika collected taxes, Rajuka was the revenue officer and Yukta was the treasurer. Okay, any doubts in this? If you have doubts, please ask me.
Yes, ma'am. What is the difference between collecting taxes and being the revenue officer?
One is only calculating and telling. One is saying, like for example, in your whole class, if there is one person who is calculating the tax that has to be paid by each person, that person is the revenue officer, Rajuka. But actually going to each person and taking the tax from him, that is the tax collector.
But the one person, one person can also do both of the stuff, right?
Yeah, you have to, is there one person, from how many people they have to collect taxes? It is not, a small number. So you need more number of people, no? So this is like division of work. So one does all the one does all the calculation and says that, from this person you collect this much tax, this person you collect this much tax. Then another person will just go and collect the tax and bring and give it.
Okay.
To whom will he give? He'll give it to the Yukta, who is the treasurer.
Okay. Thank you.
Did you understand? Because, see, again, think about this. the Rajuka or the revenue officer should have some knowledge of mathematics and other things because he should be able to collect and calculate the tax. Whereas a Pradeshika who is just going and collecting, he doesn't need to know all that, no?
Yes, ma'am.
He will only be told to go and collect 100 rupees tax from this person. He will go and collect and come. So, yes, skill-wise also, you don't need those kind of skills for certain kinds of jobs. So, are you clear now?
Yes, ma'am.
So,
thank you.
Yeah. So, that is why there were different people. So, Pradeshika, Rajuka and Yukta. Are we clear now? Anybody else has any doubt in this? Okay. So, once again, I'll do a quick summary. Please put this points in your mind. So, when I ask now itself, if somebody, you know, they should be able to answer. Shibangi is answering. I want others also to answer. So, first, provinces were under the control of Kumara or the prince. The Kumaras were assisted by Mahamatras. Ke Pradeshika was the tax collector and Rajuka was the taxation expert and Yukta was the treasurer. Pradeshika collecting taxes, Rajuka calculating taxes or revenue officer and Yukta was the treasurer. That's all. You have to remember like this. I know, you know, we may remember it temporarily. After some time, you may forget these names. So there is only one way of remembering this. You have to keep writing in the book 2-3 times. You have to write. There's no other book. Or make some acronyms and all that. PRT. P Pradeshika, R Rajuka, T, Y. PRY. Pry. Arriva. Pry is a word in English. Does anybody know what is the meaning of pry? Let me see
sneak,
your English.
I mean you,
yes, who's you that?
Sneak,
who answered that?
Like,
your voice is getting
Rucha.
Cut here.
Rucha.
Rucha. Rucha. Rucha is answering. Good.
Rucha.
Yes, I heard. Rucha. Correct. Pry means to be over curious and to try to sneak information about others. That is called prying in English. P-R-Y. Okay. So here it is coming. Pry. Remember pry. Pry. P for Pradeshika. R for Rajuka. Y for Yukta. Can you remember this? So now you will not forget. Huh? We have to make such tactics. We have to use some tactics to remember all these names. Okay, so Sannidata Samaharta also we can use like that. Let me come up with something and see. What is the previous slide? Let me go to the previous slide. What are there? Purohit, Sainapati, Sannidata, Samaharta. SSS, PSQ. Is anybody getting any idea?
PS3.
PS3. Ah, yes. PS3, PS4. You boys keep using it. Games. PS3. Yes. PS3. P. Purohit. Three S's are there. Senapati, Sannidata, Samaharta. That's it. Wow. We've come up. So, PS3 for central government. Pry for provincial government. Got it? Good. Very nice. Glad. Okay, next, let's come to district or city administration. Now, apart from this, now each province was again divided into smaller parts called districts. As we already know that these provinces were very huge, so big they were. Naturally, you need to divide them further into smaller parts called districts. Okay, even today, their states are divided into districts. Similarly, provinces were divided into districts and these districts were called Janapadas. Okay. And the head of the city was Nagaradhyaksha. Okay. Now again, children, these words look very big, big. But if you cut or break the words, it is not so difficult. City means Nagar. Correct? City means Nagar. Adhyaksha. You all know are reading from so many years in Hindi letter writing. Are you not writing Adhyaksha, Adhyaksha? formal letter writing? Yes or no? So in formal writing, you formal letter in Hindi, you write no? Adhyaksha or Adhyapika. Adhyapika is teacher, but Adhyaksha, I'm sure you have written in Hindi. Have you written this word? Adhyaksha means head. Head. Adhyaksha means nothing but head. If you have not used Adhyaksha in Hindi, you will use it now. In 9th and 10th, when you have to write formal letters in Hindi, you will be using this word very often, Adhyaksha. So it's just a combination of Nagar and Adhyaksha. Nagar Adhyaksha. Now, did you understand? So it is the head of the city. Head of the city was Nagar Adhyaksha. Okay. And according to Megasthenes, the administration of Pataliputra, the capital city of Mauryan Empire was now the city, which is like Pataliputra, which is the capital city. So the capital city, the head of the city was the Nagar Adhyaksh. And he was assisted by a committee of 30 people. 30 people helped him to manage the city. It's not very difficult to remember this. Coming to the spy system, in the Mauryan Empire, they had an elaborate spy system. Spy system is to always be informed of what is happening, what our enemies are doing, what the other country, what the neighboring kingdoms, kings are doing. Are they planning something? Are they trying to, wage a war with us? So these, you need information. And within the country also, we have a lot of people who are always trying to overthrow the king and take over the kingdom. So the king should always be very, very, what do you say? He should be very alert. Vigilant. Yeah, he should be alert and vigilant. And he must know. So that is why they had a spy system. Anushka, please tell me what is your doubt?
Yes, ma'am. I understand about the internal issues of the city. But since the Mauryan Empire, it was like the whole of India. And you told us before that the outsiders, they never usually attacked.
Outsiders means very far away people. Now see, the Mauryan Empire finally became so big. It was in stages only it became big, no? As and when they conquered and started annexing kingdoms, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is all throughout the Mauryan period we are talking. We are not talking about a single point after the whole empire was formed. We are talking what the systems were laid by Chanakya right at the beginning. Okay, right at the beginning when they had only conquered a few territories. From that time itself, they had all the systems in place. Okay. So, the spy system was very wide. It was elaborate. And an elaborate network of spies were there. And these spies, there were spies against spies. So, there were some spies who were appointed to spy on spies. Did you understand? So, because there were certain very important matters in which they did not want to rely on one person's information. So, they sometimes kept 2-3 spies to collect information on a particular topic. Or if they appointed one spy and then they kept one more spy and said that you please see whether this person is doing his job properly or whether he's reliable or not. So these were some of the tactics used by them, and that really helped them to see that, no enemy can, overthrow the king, or even, they get information beforehand if any invasions are going to happen and they can be prepared for it. Okay, so Chandragupta Maurya had a wide, see, we are talking about Chandragupta Maurya. Anushka, can you may understand this?
Yes, ma'am.
So Chandragupta Maurya had a wide network of spies in his empire. There were spies against spies, and on important matters, more than one agent was always asked to collect information. The king was always kept informed of the working of the bureaucrats. So the king always was very, very careful to know what the officers he has appointed, all the people who are holding big positions in his kingdom, what they are doing. Okay, so he always kept spies to keep him informed about what the bureaucrats are doing. So bureaucrats are nobody. They are nothing but their officers who are holding important positions. Okay? So that is the spy system. Now coming to the revenue system. Now this is a very important question, children. You have to pay attention. Revenue system is how did, what was the amount of tax they collected, or the king got money, or this thing, you know, revenue from which sources? From where did he get money to take care of the people and all that? So the land revenue was a chief source of income. Okay, naturally, it always, you know, in those days, agriculture was the main occupation. Naturally, land revenue was the chief source of income. Taxes were 1/4 or 1/6 of the produce. So how much ever the farmer produced, 1/4 or 1/6 of the produce was to be given to the king as tax. Bhaga was the agricultural tax. What is bhaga? Part. Okay. Ek bhag, do bhag, teen bhag. In Hindi, you have learned, learned all these words. So it's not difficult to understand. So then the name of the tax itself was bhaga. What is bhaga? Bhaga was the tax on produce, agricultural produce. And how much was this bhaga? It was either 1/4 or 1/6. Sometimes 1/4 was collected. Sometimes 1/6 was collected. Bali. Bali, again we know, bali means sacrifice. Correct? What is bali? Bali means sacrifice. Bali was a religious tribute. Bali and everything became banned after Ashoka became a Buddhist. Till then, sacrifices were happening in the in the temples. So bali also was a religious tax that was collected from the people. So it was a religious tribute. So can you answer? There are two types of taxes. One is bhaga, one is bali. Bhaga was a tax on the produce. Okay, agricultural produce. It was either 1/4 or 1/6. Bali was a religious tribute. Apart from bhaga and bali, what were the other taxes? One was toll tax. So those days also, when you are entering the city or something, you have to enter the city, you have to pay toll. Okay, so toll tax. Then taxes were levied on liquor and gambling, places and all that. So those days also there was all this. So liquor shops and gambling shops and all this, these places, they had to pay tax. Taxes were also collected from mines and forests. All this was used. So what did they do with the money? This was used to provide facilities for people like roads, hospitals, etc. Is it difficult, children, to understand the revenue system? No. So once again, there were two types of, mainly there were two types of taxes, bali and bhaga. Bali was a religious tax and bhaga was a part of the agricultural produce. And it was usually 1/6 or 1/4 of the produce. And apart from this, there was toll tax. There were taxes on gambling houses, liquor shops, etc. Yeah.
Ma'am, bali was a religious tribute. So it was like given in temples or something like that?
No, no. Everything was given to the king only.
It was a religious tribute in what way?
Religious tribute, but everybody had to pay that tax. See, I told you, know that the Yukta and all this Rajuka and all these people are there. Okay, they only collected all the taxes. So they collected the taxes and they deposited it with the king's treasury. So what will happen? See, all these provincial people, taxation people, will collect the tax and then they will give it to the provincial treasurer, who is the Yukta. Now the Yukta, they will keep some money for taking care of the province and rest of it they will give to the central treasury, to the king's treasury. So all the money will get deposited in the main treasury. From there it will be used. From there the king will give money to the temples for, you know, buying animals for sacrifice or whatever. So like that. So every tax, if nothing was given directly to the temples and all, everything was given to the king. Okay. So now 4 points we need to remember, children. because the maximum marks for in long answers is 4. So we should remember 4 points at least. So remember this, there were 2 types of taxes, Bali and Bhaga, point number 1. Point number 2, Bali was a religious tribute. Point number 3, Bhaga was a part of the agricultural produce. It was either 1/4 or 1/6. Point number 4, apart from this, there were toll taxes, there were taxes on liquor shops, gambling shops, etc. Okay, 4 points, you got it? That's it. So if you remember this much also, it's enough for you. Somebody's...
Ma'am, I cannot hear you.
Ariman, you can't hear me. Others could hear or only Ariman could hear?
Ma'am, Kushal is blowing into the mic. That's why I can't hear you.
Kushal, are you blowing into the mic? Everyone, please switch off your mic first. Let me see that it's all on mute. Mute yourself. Kushal, your mic is still not on mute. Okay. I'll repeat it once again. 4 points. Remember this. First one, 2 types of taxes, Bali and Bhaga. Second point, Bali is a religious tribute. Third point, Bhaga is a part of the agricultural produce that had to be paid as tax. Either 1/6 or 1/4 of the produce was charged, okay, as a Bhaga. Okay. Apart from Bali and Bhaga, there were other taxes that were levied on gambling houses, liquor shops, toll taxes, etc. That's it. Done? Okay. Now, military administration. Now we are coming to the other part. Till now we were discussing only civil administration, remember? So now we are coming to military administration. How did he take care of the army? So huge army was there. Okay, till Ashoka became a Buddhist, all these were there. All these procedures and practices were maintained. Huge army consisting of infantry, cavalry, war elephants, chariots, all these things were there. The chief weapons that were used were bows and arrows, shields, swords, etc. These are the common, you know, weapons that were there in those days. The king was commander-in-chief of the army. And there was a well-laid recruitment policy. That means whom to take into the army, recruit into the army. They had a proper procedure. And there was a proper way of selecting people for the army. Soldiers were paid in cash. Okay, so salaries were paid in cash. And then Mauryans built forts at strategic places for the safety and security of the empire. So especially in border areas where there can be invasions and all. They had some forts so that from there they can, you know, protect or they can sustain their kingdom. They can save their kingdom from any kind of invasion. So forts are nothing but big walls that were built, you know, and to secure ourselves. So the forts, the soldiers can be inside the fort and they can shoot arrows, everything on people who are outside. And to enter the fort also, it becomes very difficult for outsiders. So forts were built those days by all kings to keep their kingdom safe. So Mauryans also built forts at strategic places, means places where they perceived some threat, wherever they felt that, you know, people can enter the kingdom. This is a weak spot and this needs to be protected. There they built the forts. Clear? So military administration also is very easy. Just have to say that king was the supreme commander of the army. There was a proper recruitment policy. Soldiers were paid in cash and there was a huge standing army. The army consisted of infantry, cavalry, and elephants, chariots, etc. kind of weapons we all can imagine also, and then bows, arrows, swords, spears, etc. So that's about military administration. Ashoka's Dhamma. 1 minute. When is this? 11:40. What's the time now? It's time. It's actually time. So let me stop. We will do Ashoka's Dhamma in the next class. Anybody has any doubts? Thus far, any doubts? Krishna Nunni, can you tell me the military administration.
Sorry, ma'am.
Military administration, tell me the points.
There were cavalry and infantry, and the people, there was a large standing army.
What were the weapons used?
The weapons are swords and all. Swords. I forgot about the weapons.
So her swords, spears, shields, etc. Common ones, bows and arrows, etc. Common. Okay. And what about the soldiers? They were paid in? How were the soldiers paid?
Ma'am, may I answer?
Yes, Anushka.
The soldiers were paid in cash.
Anushka, can you also tell me about the revenue administration? What kind of taxes were there? What were the two main taxes?
Ma'am, may I try? Ma'am, the Bali and the Bhaga.
Very good. Now next, Aratrika, can you tell me what is Bali?
Ma'am, Bali was used for religious tributes.
Very good. It's a religious tribute.
And sacrifices.
Yes. Aman, what is Bhaga? Aman.
I don't remember, ma'am.
What is Bhaga? What is the meaning of Bhag? In Hindi. Bhag means what?
Run.
Bhag, not that. Ek bhag, do bhag, what is that?
Divisions.
Huh?
Divisions.
Divisions, part. That means it's a part, no? Part of what?
Of a whole.
So of what part they were giving tax?
Ma'am, can I answer?
Ma'am, were you paying attention?
Yes, ma'am.
Then, Sumer, can you tell me part of what they were giving tax?
What, ma'am?
Bhaga was a part of what?
It was for agriculture. I'm not able to.
It was a part of the produce produced by the farmers. A part of the produce of the farmers was given. That was called Bhaga. How much was that Bhaga? Arjun, how much was the Bhaga?
1/4 to 1/6
Yes, either 1/4 or 1/6. Okay, Aman, did you note down? Okay, apart from this Bhaga and Bali, which are the other taxes? Indranil, can you answer? Which were the other taxes that were imposed apart from Bali and Bhaga?
Taxes were imposed on liquor and gambling.
Yes, liquor shops,
gambling. There were toll taxes.
Toll taxes, etc. Very, very good. Okay, who will tell me the full form of PRY? PRY? Raise hands, then I can ask the chat. Shubhangi, tell.
P for Pratiksha.
Pradeshika, not Pratiksha. Okay.
And R for Rajukka.
Very
and
good.
Y for Yukta. Sorry for the
very name. Good. Pradeshika. Very good. Pradesh. See, again, province is called a Pradesh. Okay, Pradeshika. Okay, like this we have to remember, we have to connect children. If we don't connect, we cannot remember. Pradesh. Okay, province is a Pradesh. So Pradeshika. Okay? Pradeshika, Rajuka, Yukta. PRY. And what is PS3?
Amen.
Who remembers PS3? Rohan John, come on. Tell me.
Ma'am, Purohit, Sani Data,
Amartha,
and
Senapati.
Senapati, yeah.
Yeah. Very nice. So this is how we'll keep revising and remember these names, okay? So we'll see the next class, children. Next class, hopefully, please, all of you keep your books with you. We will start underlining. I'll be reading the lesson next. Next class, we have a very small part of the PPT. We'll finish it. That will take only 5 minutes. Ashoka's Dhamma is there. That will finish in 5 minutes and then we'll read the lesson and keep marking and I'll give you questions. Right?
Okay, ma'am.
Take care. Bye-bye. Have a good day.
Bye, ma'am. Bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.